What will be the most important product ever, according Elon Musk? And we're not against, we're not for Elon Musk, but we think this could be indeed the most important product ever. I'm going to talk about it in a few minutes before, but it is also that recap is needed to understand or to follow the topic where we're going to talk about. So keep watching, Martin.
Yeah, I think before we go to that insane product, we have to look back at the AI sector and the artificial intelligence sector. You know, we have a very specific approach to that. If you have been watching us for a longer extended period of time, AI is going to be very impactful. It's not going to only going to have impact on low educated people, but it's also going to have influence on highly educated people, sort of like the master degree functions, etc. So it's something that will have a definite change for everybody. How do we look at AI? We basically split it up in three subsectors. So we look at hardware. Hardware are the chips, the semiconductors. So it's the little chips that make possible that process all the data from one side of the device to another device, or put it in the cloud, etc. Semiconductors, you could buy, of course, NVIDIA, you can buy ASML, but you could also buy the Fennec Semiconductor ETF, which is an ETF that follows a basket of those main drivers of that sector. And if you look at the outlook here, where this will be heading, you see a tremendous amount of growth from here to 2030. So if you want to take advantage of that, you should maybe consider as a little block in your portfolio to include.
Little,
maybe big, yeah, depending on how much.
But the question is, I think you also spoke about with the clients, a lot of NVIDIA is the highest level ever. So people are thinking, should I sell it now? It depends. If you have a longer horizon, a few years, I think if you look at them and the forecast, the outlook, you should really consider if you should sell.
Yeah, absolutely. So the Vanek Semiconductor ETF gives you a really nice big exposure to this specific chip sector. If we look at infrastructure, of course, that data needs to be stored somewhere. So everything that you hold, everything that you process through your WhatsApp, through your iPhone, Apple, or Google, Android, somewhere that data is stored. And that is obviously not on a floppy or a hard disk, that's on a cloud-based data center somewhere. And everything that we have outstanding at this moment is being thought about 5 years ago. Everything was coming. It has to exponentially grow so much. If you're at your home at the moment, maybe have between five and 10 devices that are connected to the internet, that's going to increase to maybe 40 to 50 to 60 devices. So all those devices connected to the internet need to store their data. How can you buy an ETF? You could buy, of course, individual shares, but you could also buy an ETF. In this case, the Wisdom Tree Cloud Computing gives you exposure to also companies like Microsoft, for instance, but it allows you to benefit from the growth of data. Yeah. Because I think it's also, if you think for yourself, how often do you delete old pictures? No, you don't. You rather pay €1 extra. So that is only growing per person. If you look at yourself, the amount of pictures, I have 18,000 pictures in my iPhone. You never delete anything because that's stored in the cloud.
And the resolution is getting better and better.
It's better and better and better. So that's really important. Your pictures from 2014 or to now, it's a huge difference. And lastly, all that data needs to be protected. And also, if you look at the NAVO top, the NATO, the OTAN top, 2.5 weeks ago in The Hague, one of the points that they said is, okay, 5% we need to spend of the GDP in defense. 3.5% is more like ammunition, tanks, planes, etc., troops. But 1.5% needs to go into specifically cybersecurity, so the protection of really confidential data, but also your own data, of course. So. Yeah, because a cyber attack, it puts a country down, that of course can have significant consequences. So cybersecurity is growing and growing and growing and will not be smaller than it is at the moment. Where can you invest in? The First Trust Nasdaq Cybersecurity ETF. ETF listed on the stock market of Italy. Good ETF gives you exposure to, for instance, Palantir and CrowdStrike. So there's big players that are active in this field. Now, Casper, you're going to tell us something that we all maybe have seen, but we don't know so much about. And it's scary as well as it is fascinating. What are we talking about?
Humanoid robots. Some of you maybe know a lot about it. Some of you only saw maybe one video about it. The latest presentation of Tesla a few months ago, Elon Musk presented two things. The new self-driving taxi without the steering wheel, without the dashboard. He was sitting in it and there was hardly no attention to it. On the same during the same presentation, he also introduced the new Optimus, the humanoid robot of Tesla. They walk into the room, he said, be careful, be gentle to them. And they start taking beer from the beer tap, talking to people. We have some videos, you can also look for yourself, but we have some videos we try to put them under or in between his video. And then you see a guy standing outside talking to one of those Optimuses, and there is a real interaction. And this is not future music, this is now, this is already now, and this is going so fast. I follow a few of those companies, and then you see what they every week, what they present, how fast it goes. It is tremendously. And I think that with those humanoid robots, the next years will be amazing. The next 5 years will be fantastic. From an economical perspective, productivity will go up. So we're all, our economies will benefit from it because we can produce much more, much better, because those robots can work faster and longer than humans. So from an economical perspective, fantastic. And also, I think that we have also videos about it, that what you see, how he or she or it can move is already amazing. And we will have a lot of people will have a humanoid robot in our house. And in the beginning, it's fantastic because that robot makes coffee for you. The doorbell goes, Amazon package, the robot goes and takes the package. After that, he's going to do the grass, the swimming pool. And meanwhile, he protects you, and if somebody comes close to the house, he or she or it knows, and it will do something about it. So that it helps us out. And of course, it is such a robot will not be cheap. It's expected about $30,000, so it's not for everyone. First problem.
I mean, if you think about it, sorry to interrupt you, but if you look at the amount of people that are capable of, we also get 20,000-30,000 euros, and it's not to say that you are, but it's not that cheap.
No.
The vast majority of the people are not able to buy that. They can't even afford a car, you know. So why would them then buy a robot? You know, it's only for the elites, I think.
There's the first problem starts. Mm-hmm. Musk says about his own company, it's about $1 trillion the value, and he thinks that with the self-driving cars, it will be valuated 5 times higher, $5 trillion, and with the humanoid robots, it will be 25 around. So also from an investment perspective, but I come back on that later, is it really interesting. But later on, those robots can replace so many people, what you mentioned, not only people that do light scaled work, but also people that have functions within a PhD. It will replace so much, and if you replace too much humans, at the end, it's really bad for those humans, first of all, most important thing, but also for the economy. So where it's going to end, I don't know. Hopefully, we as human race are capable to introduce law and regulation on a worldwide level. That will be in place in time, because this is going so fast, much faster than we as humans can handle, I think. How can you invest in it? You can do two things. I think you can invest directly in those producers of those humanoid robots. The problem is there that most of those companies are not on the stock market, so they're difficult to invest in. Five of the most important ones you can see in the screen now, one of them at the top is Tesla, and then number two, the Boston Dynamics. The CEO said after the presentation of the latest Optimus, he said, wow, Tesla is quite far in this. And they are focusing completely on those humanoid robots. And Tesla does it on the side. And then I think China is really important in this topic. You see less about it, but in the screen, five of the most important ones for now, but that can change next week. Also, it's really difficult to buy because they're not on the stock market, but Xiaomi is on the stock market, and they make also quite interesting robots. And if you want to take that a little bit broader, you want to invest not in that share, but in the IT sector of China, there is an ETF we put on the screen that you can also invest in. I said you can invest in it through two ways. You can invest through in companies that make those robots directly. But you can also, going back to Martin's story, what do the robots need? Those robots, they don't have a heart, they don't have a liver, they're completely full of chips.
Chips.
NVIDIA chips, semiconductors. It is all about data. Where's the data stored? In the cloud.
Wow.
You don't want that your neighbor has access in your computer so he or she can do things with your computer, and that's in a positive example.
Your robot.
Yeah. It needs to be protected. It needs to have cybersecurity tools on a high level. So you can also say, I believe in this sector, AI sector. AI is also getting more physical, but those three subsectors that we defined, they are so important. I invest more in those, in fact, because I believe in those humanoid robots.
Yeah.
One thing we didn't mention in the story, Martin.
That is the energy. Where does all the energy come from? Because if you think about it, one search on Google is like leaving a light on for 10 minutes. And if you look at ChatGPT, how much is that again? That's even worse.
12 minutes of this laptop.
12 minutes usage of a laptop for one search.
Yeah.
So, yeah, what is going to be the solution for that? Who's going to, what is going to create all that energy?
Uranium?
Uranium, maybe, yeah. And also for that, there's really interesting ETF. I'm just going to mention it, the VanEck Uranium and Nuclear Sector ETF. There's a lot of things to said about, and it's maybe the most powerful energy that you can think of, because you need very little of it, mm-hmm. and it can create a lot of power. So, yeah, maybe there's a big opportunity for rain.
Awesome. Humanoid robots. I think that I agree with Elon Musk.
Scary, but also fascinating.
So,
thank you for watching.
Let us know your comments.
And we'll see you next week.
Kiitos, Jutta.